and welcome back to this channel. My name is Sarah, a poly francophone qui regarde. N'hésitez pas à mettre les sous-titres, je les ai créés pour vous. In today's video, I wanted to show you my sewing plans for early summer. And I say early summer because I love the summertime. It's my favorite season. My birthday's coming up. It's my birthday season. And I love wearing and making clothes in the summertime. And usually I have so many ideas in my head of the summer clothes that I want to make and wear that I don't get to them all. It's impossible to get to them all because I have a very long list of summer clothes that I'd like to make. And so I've tried to keep this list doable because I know that I have also been experiencing a slight lull in sewing motivation and wanting to get to new projects, and I need to take into account the fact that I am a slower sewist, and I don't want to feel that same frustration that I feel every year when the weather starts getting cold again, that I haven't finished all the projects that I wanted to finish in the summertime. At the same time, I am very much drawn to brighter colors and print fabrics in the summertime, and so I have a lot of clothes that I love, but that don't entirely mix and match very well in my wardrobe, because now that I've been sewing for about 5 years, I have a lot of pieces for the summertime. My wardrobe isn't complete. I wouldn't say it's complete. I still have many things to make that are basics, but they don't mix and match very well. So I've been craving more staples and more solid color fabrics so that they can mix and match a little bit better. Also, I've been feeling a little bit timid about getting back into sewing. I have just finished a really big project, as in my wedding dress for my wedding, and I took a little bit of a break because not only was it such a huge event and I needed a little bit of a break in general, but I was in the end very emotionally invested in making my wedding dress, and it's very hard to let go of. I'm not used to making a project that you only wear once and then never wear again, and I spent so much time on it that I'm having a very hard time now moving on to other things. But I did make a skirt recently, and I vlogged the entire project. If you'd like to check out that video, I'll link it here. That definitely kind of got my sewing motivation motors going again and got me back into my sewing corner and back into thinking about more regular projects that don't take 5 months. So I am excited. So today I have 6 projects to share with you. They range quite greatly from easy to not so easy, to daring, to definitely frosting, sewing frosting, which is a newer phrase that has been coming up online a lot about clothes that you make just for the fun of it because they're not very practical but they're pretty, and that is definitely what I'm making for my birthday coming up mid-July. But I am really excited about these, so without further ado, let me show you the first one. So the first project that I need to get to soon is actually for a baby. One of my very good friends just had her first baby, and I would like to make a handmade gift. So what I plan to do with these 2 cotton double gauze fabrics, so I have one in more of a mustardy color and one that's complementary in like white with little beige and pinky flowers, I figured they go together well, and I'd like to make another bunny lovey like I made for another friend's baby back in September. And that is a tutorial in French on the Instagram account Petite Peur. I will link her account below if you'd like to follow it, but it is in her saved stories and not on a blog or anything. So it does take a little bit of time to listen and write down the instructions, but it's very good. Then I want to also, I think I'll have enough to make also a little baby blanket. I figure maybe a square of 65 or 75 centimeters. And I want to try my hand at quilting it. So not cutting out different pieces, but like just sewing quilting lines to keep the fabrics together and maybe adding a layer of wadding between, but making it double-sided. So one side this color, one side that color. And then with any scrap fabric, I want to make little drool bibs because I saw with other friends who have babies that they're very practical for keeping clothes clean, just like stick on a little drool bib sometimes. And I figured I'd probably have maybe 1 or 2 scraps big enough to make that. And I found a pattern online by Gray House Harbor. Just this one, it's a free pattern. I'll link it also in the description below. But it looks pretty easy, pretty doable. The baby was just born, and I would definitely like to get her this present before this video comes out, so I will need to sew that up and send it right away. But I think they will be pleased, or I hope they will be, and I am excited to get to that soon. The next project that I would like to get to is with this viscose crepe polka dot fabric that you have very likely already seen in my Seamwork Pauline skirt vlog. I have enough fabric to make another garment, and I was originally considering making the Helen's Closet Donovan skirt, and that is a pattern that I've made multiple times before that I wear all the time. It's a very easy garment to wear. It's at the same time I find elegant but also very casual, as in it's very comfortable to wear. It's got a wide elasticated waist and side slits and pockets. It's great for light fabrics with a lot of drape, like this viscose crepe, and so I think that I would be really happy to get another skirt out of this. And I want to make another skirt because the first skirt that I made, the Seamwork Pauline skirt, is a little bit more business casual and a little bit more formal, and I want to make something even more informal and casual that I can wear just around the house, on the weekends, on vacation. And what I love about this fabric, and what is also very difficult about this fabric, is that it doesn't crease, but that also means that it does not react to any kind of heat. I cannot press it, and folding over seam allowances or, you know, trying to press the seams open or things like that, it's very, very hard with this fabric. But I'm excited that I can get more than one garment out of this cut of fabric, and I'm really happy about that in the end. The next project is actually something that I've been debating for quite a while, so let me know what you think. But I received this fabric. So this is a cotton poplin fabric. It's got a nice tight weave, and it's very smooth, and it's got this white and black crosshatch sort of design. This is two layers. Let me show you one layer. Here's one layer. So it is very crisp, and I've been wondering what to do with this. So this is not actually fabric that I chose myself. This was sent to me for free by Mister Tissu, which is a fabric shop, or online fabric shop here in France. I think they might have a store in the north of France, I'm not sure. But it doesn't come with any kind of obligation to make anything or review it, but I did want to mention that I got this for free. So I have 2 meters of this fabric, and for years I've been wondering what to do with it. Because it is very loud, but I think that I have finally found what I want to do with it. I want to try and make a seamwork Una dress again. I made one last summer in a pink floral fabric, and I did add a bit of a modification. I lowered the waistband elastic 3 centimeters, and so I need to go back and add that to the pattern because I ended up just fiddling and modifying the finished garment after. But I like that that dress has a very simple streamlined shape, but it's also quite feminine. I like that the neckline is high and kind of more classic, and I think that this fabric, although it is loud for me, I think that it looks okay next to my face, and that it would look kind of nice in a dress. We'll see if I'll make it. I really want to, and the sew over at Una dress is a very easy, quick sew, so I could definitely make it in a few days, and it would be a very satisfying sew. But I'm not sure if I have the courage to wear this fabric. I think it will definitely grab attention, and I have to be in a certain mood, I think, to wear this. But I do really want to make it, and I think that the black and white is sort of a very classic combination. I like that the crosshatch is not entirely straight, and that the lines kind of wiggle a little bit. I think in the end, it's going to be the most easiest and satisfying sew for me this summer. So that will do me good. The next project is the frosting I was talking about, and it will be for my birthday. And it is with this absolutely gorgeous fabric. This is a viscose fabric, and I bought it from Sacré Coupon, which is a fabric shop in Paris, also online. And I love the colors in this fabric. This is, I don't know, a lot of my favorite colors, and I love the contrast with the sort of yellows and greens, and I call it my mermaid fabric, and I don't know why. I think because it has a bit of a shine to it, like a silvery shine. And I love this fabric, and so I would like to make something with it for my birthday, and I have had this fabric for over a year, and I've been wondering what to do with it, but then I recently saw the True Bias Laura dress that just came out, and I thought, that might go. I'm a little bit worried about it because it will be a little bit complicated for 2 reasons. The smallest size does not correspond to my bust size. I'm smaller than their smallest size, so I'll have to manually grade down the pattern a hypothetical smaller size, one size down, which is time consuming. And then I was also a little bit worried about the Empire waistline because I have typically a 2 size difference between my waist and my hips, and typically Empire dresses, when they kind of skim over the belly, they make me look pregnant. Which is a look, and it's not necessarily a bad look on everybody, but I don't really like that line on me. And so I'm a little bit worried about that, but I definitely want to try it because it looks very pretty. I like the gathers underneath the bust. I like that they're not too high because a lot of those sorts of shapes are much higher on the bust instead of underneath. I think it's very complimentary that way. And I like that the back seam sort of goes down a bit and emphasizes the waist rather than staying up along the back. And then I noticed that the shape of the pattern definitely allows for a curve and doesn't just kind of drape. And so I've seen it on other makers who have made this pattern and who have body shapes a little bit more like mine, as in not straight or one size up and down, but two different sizes. And it looks very complimentary on them too. So I'm thinking of making that. I definitely like the detail of the buttons down the middle, and I do want to shorten the length. I want to make it just below the knees instead of the midi length. Like they have it even, it's a little bit of a longer midi length as well. And I want to make the version without the sleeves. I think it's going to be interesting. I hope it goes well because I love this fabric. And if in the end it turns out to be not very complimentary to me, I'm not sure what I'm going to do about it, but yeah, that is my plan for my birthday and my birthday dress. And I love this fabric and I'm really excited to get to it. The second to last project that I have on my, it turns out to be quite ambitious list for the early summer, is with this fabric. So this is this, what would you call it? Celadon or sea green, maybe sea green viscose fabric from Tomato Fabrics in Nippori in Tokyo. This is one of the fabrics that I bought that you may have seen in my Tokyo fabric shopping video, which I will also link. And I love this fabric. Like, look at this. I think it's coming up a little bit more blue on the camera. I see blue, but it's a lot greener in real life. Maybe if I approach it to the camera. Yeah, a little bit. And you can kind of see it's got this slubby texture to it, and I just absolutely adore it. It's got this beautiful hang to it. It's quite heavy. I think it's maybe what you would call a bottom weight, I'm not sure. And I have 3 meters, and I think I would like to make a Allie Olson Highland dress. I've made this dress 3 times before. Yeah, 3 times before. And I have one in black, just a solid color, that I wear all the time. And I think that it's much easier for me to wear solid colors when it's head to toe than a print. I end up gravitating towards it and wearing a lot more every day at work, for example. And I think that this would be a great everyday dress to wear in the summer and probably spring, I think, because it's thicker, it'll keep me a little bit warmer. And at the same time, these side slits in the leg part are breezy and airy, and I'm never too warm in a Highland dress, and I really like wearing it. I think that because it's not too strappy, it keeps me a little bit more warm in the air conditioning at work. And I wear this dress all the time in the summertime, and so I'm excited to make something that I know I will wear a lot with this fabric because I love this fabric, and I'm excited to work with it. It's so nice. This is why I love summertime and summer fabrics, is because I get to work with viscose. And I love viscose. So yeah, I am excited to get to this and show you what I make with it. So the last project that I would like to get to is a little bit out of my comfort zone, and it is a Bella Loves pattern rosy shirt in this really lovely white linen, this light white linen that I got from Tissu de Rêve, which is another fabric shop based online in Paris. I think they have a shop in Paris as well. And I was wondering what to do with this fabric because it is not opaque. It is definitely kind of see-through, and so I couldn't make a dress or something out of it. But I do love wearing white, and I do love working with linen in the summertime as well. I think it's very easy to sew. It just feels really nice. It's got sort of a bounce to it, which I think is really lovely. And so I decided to make a button-down shirt. The Bella Loves pattern, or rosy shirt, is an oversized button-down shirt with a lower V-neck collar, I think, than regular shirts, and drop shoulders and a little bit more volume in the back. And she made it in her sample pictures in a silk, and it just looked really beautiful. And I've been seeing that silhouette more and more in Paris, just walking around. People wearing high-waisted jeans or pants, and then a sort of oversized drop-shoulder shirt with open collar, and I find it really beautiful. The emphasis of the collarbones, I find that a very pretty sort of feminine area of the body, and I like emphasizing that too sometimes. And so I want to try that silhouette, and I also want to try this new pattern from Bella Loves Patterns because her patterns are so beautifully designed, and the finishing techniques and sewing techniques that she describes in her patterns and that are featured in her patterns are very clever, I find. And whenever I make one of her patterns, I feel like I've gotten something that is very couture level of sewing. It's not just easy, fast finishings like you get with other sewing patterns, which is not necessarily a bad thing, but I do really appreciate when the details on the inside are as carefully designed as the outside, especially because I'm a slow sewer and I don't mind taking extra time to make sure the inside is beautiful. And I always learn something new with her patterns, and I'm really excited to get to that. So even though it may not work out as a garment that I love to wear and that works with my silhouette, I think that the sewing experience is going to be really interesting and fun. So those are all the sewing projects I have for the early summer, and I think it is a little bit ambitious, but it's okay if I don't get to everything. It's more important to enjoy the process and take my time, I think, and I'm excited about all of these projects. I have linked all of the patterns in the description below. Today I am wearing a Tilly and the Buttons sarin dress that I made, I think, a year or two ago, and if you'd like to check that project out, I posted on Instagram all about it with all the details, so don't hesitate to check that out as well. Let me know what you have planned for the summertime, any ambitious projects or events that are coming up in the summer for you. It's always really interesting for me to see what you're working on per season, and it gives me ideas as well. I hope that you are all doing well, and I will see you again here soon. Bye-bye.